We are in Uberlândia, studying in the regional encounter in which we have representatives from all the states and from other states, as Chibucho Marcos, who is next to me, and we will together explain a little bit about Tanto Jutsu today. I am Uchideshi Francisco.
Meu nome é Marcos Rocha, sou do Chibucho do Rio de Janeiro, eu graduei. E ao meu lado está o senhor Francisco Uchideshi, Uberlândia, Minas Gerais.
As we know in Tanto, it is very important the anatomical study. It is so important that in our school it became one of the main studies in this particular discipline. So as we will see, we will study today the first, the Ipaume Suburi, and the targets in which we have the strikes, so to understand better why and how we may or may not attack those targets. Okay. To start, we will perform the first three movements. So, as you saw, they are very alike with each other. In the first one, we come back a bit and then strike this region. This region aims the heart. We have a wrong impression about the heart. We think it's in the left side, but it's not. It's most of it is in the middle of the chest. A bit of it is in the left side, but we think it's mainly there. It's not true. But the three movements aim the heart. The first aims the heart through the sternum, which is a bone in this region of the thorax. The other two aim the sternum from other approaches. The second from the right for the tori and from the left for the uke, aims the heart through the cartilage, the connective tissue that connects the ribs, the bones, to the sternum, other bone. Or in the third movement, by the left for the tori and the right for the uke, it aims the heart through the same approach but in the other side, or from the abdomen. Or what does it mean? It means that the strike comes from down, where there is no thoracic bone, no protection, and goes up to the heart. Now Chibucho Marcos will explain the other two movements in the Ipaume Suburi Tanto. He will speak in Portuguese, and then I'll translate his words so we all can understand. Okay.
Bem, vou explicar agora sobre as estocadas a nível de pescoço e cabeça.
Okay, he said that now he will explain about the strikes in the neck and the head.
Bem, essas estocadas a nível de pescoço são duas do lado direito, duas do lado esquerdo. Tem um objetivo, a primeira estocada, que é uma estocada de baixo para cima. Os antigos falavam que era para atingir as amígdalas. A gente observa, estudando mais detalhadamente a parte anatômica, que essa estocada ela vai perfurar essa base da mandíbula, penetrar na boca do adversário, perfurar o palato mole e atingir toda a base de encéfalo.
So, he said that we have two strikes to the neck. And the first one is the one in which we have the movement from up to down, upwards. And that this movement was taught by the ancient teachers, that it aims the amygdala. which can be a structure in the brain, depending on how we interpret it. So it goes from the base of the neck, from the up part of the neck, base of the mandibula, and through the mouth, and then erupts through the base of the skull and gets in the central nervous system.
Bem, essa outra estocada, o alvo a ser atingido é a carótida interna, tanto do lado direito quanto do lado esquerdo, promovendo assim a morte em poucos minutos do seu adversário.
So this is the second movement in each side in which we aim the neck. It aims an artery, which is called a carótida. The section of this artery makes the death of the uke in a few minutes or a few seconds, depending on a few things.
Esses novos ataques, eles estão visando uma região importante do crânio. Estão visando um ponto de referência importante, que é exatamente a fontanela que existe nessa região temporal. Fontanela é essa, chamada de astério. E tanto do lado direito quanto do lado esquerdo.
So these last strikes aim an important structure in the skull, which is a junction of bones in the temporal region called astério. And goes through the skull and inside the head.
Esse novo ataque vai atingir um ponto de referência extremamente importante também no crânio, atingir o ápex do crânio. Essa região também é denominada de fontanela bregmática. Principalmente no período neonatal, assim, é observado com grande facilidade, porque essa região está aberta. Os antigos professores, eles já sabiam disso, que essa região é chamada também de muleira. Então, você tem acesso através dessa região, essa fontanela bregmática, ao encéfalo.
So, in this last strike, the last of the ipomé, we aim the apex of the skull, And the apex is also called bregma, and is a junction of bones. And it was already known by the ancient masters and teachers, as for the ones who worked with labor and delivering the child, that it in the newborn it is an open space. There is no bone protecting the skull there, and therefore, even in the adult person, it is a sensitive region for a strike in the head. So the strike in this region aims directly the encephalus, and therefore possibly a deadly strike. So with these concepts, we can start the anatomical study in this ipomé suburi of Tanto Jutsu. It is a very important study. We aim to accomplish a lot more in this way. And thanks for